Welcome friends, my name is Jay and you are watching Medical TubeMate. In this video I am going to talk about APC-CPC exam, how to prepare for CPC exam and chapter wise and section wise breakdown and what are the things have to prepare in each chapter. Then I will give some tips and tricks to pass this exam. So let us get started without wasting a single time. So friends, structure of APC-CPC examination. The APC-CPC, APC means American Academy of Professional Coders and CPC means Certified Professional Coder. This exam consists of 150 multiple choice questions and test taker have 5 hours and 40 minutes to complete this exam. Unlike many other certification exams, the CPC exam is an open book exam. In fact, test taker must bring copy of ICD-10 CPT and HCPCS manual to the exam. So ICD-10, this copy consists of diagnosis code and CPT consists of procedural code and HCPCS consists of supplement codes and drugs codes. The exam consists of 17 different content area and each content area consists of 8 to 10 questions. In what follows, we break down each content area. We begin the providing some general tips on how to prepare for this unique and challenging certification exam. I have already posted one video which is CPC exam pattern 2021, which is the summary of this video. You can go and you can check this video as well. It's a summary, and then you can see here also in this video I am giving proper chapter wise and content wise content and how to prepare for this exam. So let's start. So what to expect and how to prepare. The APC-CPC covers many topics. As a result, it is important to have a clear plan as you prepare for the exam. Among other things, to be certain, familiarize yourself with how to access information in all three manuals like ICD, CPT and HCPCS. You are not being tested on your ability to memorize thousands of codes, but rather on your ability to locate these codes in an accurate expedient manner. Bring all three manuals to the test. If you don't, you are bound to fail. Sometimes APC is providing a ICD, CPT and HCPCS books, but you have to confirm before. Then you are permitted to bookmark frequently using section of manual. So as you prepare for the exam, you are also permitted to make marginal notes on your manual copies. Since you won't need to a perfect score to pass, if a question is particularly long and complex, skip it and move on to the next question. Aim to answer at least 80% of the question correctly, because you will need 70% marks to pass this actual exam. So content area 1, this is 10,000 series of CPT book. So expect 10 questions on the subject of surgical procedure performed on the integumentary system. By definition, the integumentary system is an organ that protects the body from damage. Skin, nail and hair are all part of this system. On the exam, you may also come across question concerned with cyst. You should understand the system function part and connection to the disease. So surgical procedure performed on integumentary system, for all the surgical procedure you have to assign CPT code from 10,000 series of CPT book. Then next, content area 2, this is 20,000 series of CPT book. Be prepared to respond to at least 10 questions on the topic of surgical procedure performed on musculoskeletal system. So 20,000 series means it's on musculoskeletal system, including those part of the system located in the head, neck, back, spine, abdomen, shoulder, arm, hand, finger, pelvis, hip, leg, foot and toes. So very simple, surgical procedure performed on musculoskeletal system, then this CPT codes comes under in 20,000 series of your CPT book. Then next, content area 3, this is 30,000 series of your CPT book. This will also be a total of 10 question concerns with surgical procedure carried out on the following four system. Means you can expect 10 question from this content area. And this consists of respiratory system, cardiovascular system, hemic and lymphatic system, mediastinum and diaphragm. So you can expect 10 questions from this four system. So be careful while assigning 30 series CPT because it's having lots of guidelines. So be careful and prepare well for this 30,000 series. Then next, content area 4. This is 40,000 series CPT code. So you can expect 10 questions here also. 10 questions will focus on surgical procedure performed on digestive system, which include lips, mouth, palate, salivary gland, esophagus, stomach, intestine, appendix, rectum, anus, liver, biliary tract, pancreas, abdomen, peritoneum and omentum. So you can expect 10 questions from this surgical procedure performed on digestive system. So you will get all the surgical codes in 40,000 series belongs to the digestive system. Then next content area is 50,000 series of your CPT book. Also expect to encounter 10 questions. Here also you can expect 10 questions concerned with surgical procedure carried out on the following four system and situation: urinary system, male reproductive system, female reproductive system, then maternity and delivery cords and endocrine system. So guys, next content area 6. It's having 60,000 series of your CPT book. 10 questions pertaining to surgical procedure performed on nervous system. Means you can expect 10 questions from surgical procedure performed on nervous system. For example, procedure performed on brain, spine and extracranial and peripheral nerve. The next content area 7, evaluation and management. You can expect 10 questions from this section. 10 questions group under evaluation and management focus on type of service provided in special department and under special condition. In this section, expect to find question that test your knowledge of your following topic. So whenever you start solving mock and studying CPC exam and CPT, then you can find in evaluation and management having different type of services. Then you can find office and outpatient service, then hospital observation CPT codes and levels, then hospital inpatient, consultation, emergency department, critical care, nursing facility, domiciliary and rest home, home service, prolonged service, care management, care plan, oversight, preventive medicine, non-face-to-face service, then special ENM, then newborn care, neonatal and pediatric critical care and intensive care, then complex chronic care coordination and transition care management. So you can find this many type of evaluation and management services performed under evaluation and management. So you can expect 10 questions from content area 7, which is evaluation and management. And evaluation and management's code series starting from 99. So you know CPT code having 5-digit number, so it's started from 99, so series will be 99. The next content area is anesthesia. So you can expect 8 questions from anesthesia section. One of the most expensive part of medicine is a distinct content area on the AAPC CPC. Be prepared to respond to question on reporting qualifying circumstances, physical status modifier and anesthesia for surgical and diagnostic and obstetrical services. So you can expect 8 questions from anesthesia. The next content area 9, this is for radiology. There will be 10 questions. You can expect 10 questions on radiology, including specific questions on diagnostic radiology and ultrasound, mammography, bone and joint study, oncology and nuclear medicine broadly defined. Then content area 10, laboratory pathology. So you can expect 8 question. Another key content area concern laboratory pathology. On this section of the exam, be prepared to respond to the question on any of the following topic: organ and disease panel, drug testing, therapeutic drug assay, evacuation testing, consultation, urinalysis, molecular pathology, MAAA, chemistry, hematology and coagulation, immunology, transfusion, microbiology, anatomic pathology, cytopathology, cytogenic study, surgical pathology, in vivo and reproductive course. The next content area is 11. This is for medicine. So the test will also present 10 questions. You can expect 10 questions on topic in medicine pertaining to any of the following specific knowledge area. So you can find immunization codes under medicine, psychiatric codes, biofeedback, dialysis, gastroenterology, ophthalmology codes, otorhinolaryngology, cardiovascular, non-invasive vascular study, pulmonary, allergic, immunology, endocrine, neurology, genetics. So like that, guys, moderate sedation is very important. This comes under in medicine, medical nutrition, dermatology, hydration and infusion codes, then injection codes, chemotherapy codes, all are comes under in medicine section. So you can expect 10 questions from medicine section. Content area 12 is medical terminology, and you can expect 8 questions on medical terminology pertaining to system of the human body. For example, be prepared to respond to the question about part and function of the circulatory system and part and function of the skeletal system. Content area 13 is anatomy. So be prepared for 8 questions on anatomy in relation to all system in the human body. So you can expect 8 questions. Then next content area 14. This is ICD-10-CM and diagnosis. 10 questions will focus on ICD-10. ICD-10 official guideline for coding and reporting, and on diagnosis question. Notable diagnosis question may also appear elsewhere on the exam. The next content area 15, HPICS level 2. 5 questions will focus on modifier, two digit code that modify another service or procedure, includes supplies code, medication and professional service for Medicare patient. Then next content area 16 on coding guideline. So you can expect 6 questions. Focus on ICD-10 official guideline for coding and reporting, and on CPT coding guideline and notes. Once again, this means you should know as much as possible about both of these manuals. The next content area is 17, compliance and regulatory, and you can expect 5 questions from this content area. We'll focus on compliance regulation. As result, be prepared to answer question on at the following subject. So following subjects such as service covered under Medicare Part A, B, C, D, then HIPAA, then CCI dates, NCD and LCD policy, then ABN, then RVU, and how to apply coding to payment policy, and how to identify and report fraud and abuse. So guys, I hope you understand everything, and I will explain each content area with proper ICD and CPT guidelines. So if you like my video, then please like, share and subscribe Medical TubeMate. And if you have any question regarding this or any guidelines, so you can ask me in comment box. And if you want this PDF file, I will share.